Now, the starting lineup for your Seneca Golden Eagles. Senior number four defenseman, Owens Bonilla Hernandez. Senior number two forward, Jonathan DeFrank. Junior goalkeeper, Ethan Audie. Number 19, senior defender, Steven Oliva. Senior goalkeeper, Sean Casey. Junior midfielder, number 16, Sam McHugh. Freshman midfielder, number 13, Mark Aladino. Senior goalkeeper, Jonah Mikulski. Sophomore, forward number 11, Elkin Bonilla Hernandez. Junior forward, number 18, Luke Leach. Sophomore midfielder, number 5, Shane Lovett. Senior forward, number 10, Eric Pierre. Senior forward, number 15, Scotty Sproul. Senior midfielder, number 17, John Miele. Senior midfielder, number 14, Mitchell Tippin. Senior midfielder, number 24, Zachary Bryda. Senior defender, number 21, Tommy Fox. Senior defender, number 9, Drew Gallagher. And senior defender, number 6, Justin Patton. And our last player to be introduced, the senior defender, number 12, Owen Lovett. The Golden Eagles. Coaching staff, Mr. Sam Myra, Mr. Chris Melagrana, Mr. Rocky Panarella, Mr. Ron Jensen, and Mr. Mike Manna.
All right, here we are, Seneca family, soccer.
After a wonderful season, 2019, Seneca boys soccer.
Let's go over the accomplishments.
Why don't we introduce ourselves first?
Okay.
All right.
John?
Who am I? John Miele.
Today and only.
And this is Eric Pierre.
Eric Pierre. And this gentleman here is
Tom
Fox. I got to tell you, at the beginning of the season, if someone had asked me, for $1,000 just to have the kind of ending that we ended up with, I would have gladly given that up.
It was almost storybook. First time ever that Seneca won the Group 3 championship for boys soccer.
Undefeated season.
Regular season with
regular
13
season.
Don't
shutouts.
Forget about the Shawnee comeback. That started the whole thing going.
First game of the season. So this year, all three of us had boys that were seniors that played on the team. And we just felt so much pride in the season. But to start it off at Shawnee, their home turf, down 2-0, 16 minutes in the game, and we thought, oh my God, what's this season gonna be?
I gotta tell you, John Miele was giving me the play-by-play. And I was in the middle of work. Once I heard they were up 2-0, I turned my phone off.
But that game was really the beginning. That was the first bookend of a great season.
Yeah.
Like that, we said, okay, this isn't going to happen. We're not going to have this the same way we happened last year, where we just lose the game. No. We had kids step up. Sam McHugh.
Correct.
Right.
Yeah.
Who else?
Sam.
Scotty.
Scotty Sproul had the game tying goal.
And I think once that. We won that game. I think the boys, something clicked inside of them. Like, we could beat anybody.
I'd have to take it back even a little bit before that. Summer League, these guys were unbelievable.
Right, Bishop Eustace.
They were beating everybody.
Right.
You know? So they felt, it felt that something good, something amazing
was about
to happen.
They had that chemistry that you don't always feel.
get.
And actually, that was the game when your son walked off the field and said, "I'm not afraid of anybody." And
yeah.
I'm like, "We're gonna kick butt this year."
So that worked out really well.
And we did.
Yep.
And then they went on this amazing run of always holding the lead, scoring first, playing relaxed, feeling like they could accomplish anything.
Yeah.
Jonah Mikulski.
Oh yeah.
Goalie of the year.
Owen Lovett.
Shutouts.
Owen Lovett.
Owen Lovett.
Drew Gallagher.
Oh, Gallagher.
Tommy Fox.
Yeah.
Justin Patton.
Yep.
Probably the most solid four black players that kept our shutouts, helped Jonah keep those shutouts.
Every game there was something new and exciting that happened. And every game they started building with more momentum.
That's it.
And they thought as a team, that chemistry was undeniable on that field.
We had some, I mean, let's go through all the players and all the, I mean, Mitch.
Just attacking the ball in midfield.
Attacking the ball in midfield. We had up top, we had Luke and we had Elkin.
Yep. And Luke Leach set the record this year for 18 goals.
He's got two goals before he breaks Zach Malcolm's record. So, I mean, every player on that field.
The way we, on our own field, sectional title to win that game.
Oh, Pineland. That was Eric's goal.
Yep. And I remember.
That was Pineland.
After the game, Tom turned around, and I think he might have taken a picture of the sky.
Of the skyline.
The skyline
just a beautiful
was
setting,
just
and it was
stuff.
It was movie perfect. There's a picture of Johnny Mealy and Tom Fox jumping up, bumping backs together, and they're at least 3.5 feet off the ground. And it's just, you could see sheer excitement.
Great stuff.
You know, all the boys hugging and being there together, it was something that was fantastic. Good. I wanted to kind of say that for all of us as parents of players, what an incredible senior year, what an incredible experience. The coach led them as they were going all through the year and kind of developed the boys. There were certainly conversations that happened throughout the season. Undeniably one of the most exciting seasons I've ever witnessed.
I gotta second that.
I third that.
All right, with that said, coach, great job. Congratulations.
Thanks so much for an awesome season.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
Great. Eric Pierre, John Mealy, Tom Fox, thanks so much. Coach
Seneca.
Go Seneca.
Let's go.
Throughout this season, it was interesting because as it started taking on some steam and we started having some success, many reporters wanted to know, you know, what are you doing as a coach? What have you done? What are your, you know, your tactics and your techniques? And over and over again, I kept, you know, reflecting it back to the team. I said, you know, this year, I haven't scored one goal. I don't have one assist. I haven't made a save. But these kids set a goal for themselves.
A lot of the seniors had actually been four-year players, a lot three-year players, and just kind of having that familiarity all 4 years and kind of building and building, each year getting better and better. And by the time we got here, these seniors, they were just kind of ready to go.
This team, I think, had a lot of qualities that I've seen in other championship teams. They really held each other accountable. They demanded the best from each other.
When I was in high school, we won the state championships my junior year. And I started seeing a lot of similarities between that championship team and this team. And the biggest thing I can say was we both had the ability to gather all the time we've had playing soccer and put it into the moment.
From the beginning of the year to the end of the year, there were definitely changes in tactics and maybe how we use players. And I think us working together for 15, 16, however many years it was, also really, really helped out.
What we did as a coach and as a coaching staff was try to prepare them for the moment. Meaning, we prepared them well. They understood our system of play. Many of these guys have been with us for many, many years. And then when their moments came, they were ready. And that to me is a part of a good team is that they're ready for that moment. And sometimes, honestly, that moment doesn't come. This year, we're fortunate that the moment came many, many times for us, and a varied number of players, really succeeded for us in big, big moments.
Your job as a coach with a team that has a lot of talent and a lot of cohesion is to get them pointed in the right direction and let them lead the team there.
These kids on this team, these players, often talked about the traveling teams they were on together when they were younger and how this was a culmination of that moment. And you could see in every single game that the youth in them, the kid in them, was playing soccer. And with that youth came that passion and love for the game. And they used that love to inspire winning. They weren't ready to let the game end or let the year end without giving it everything they had.
Really pays off, because you have to do less motivation. You can worry about who is playing where, your substitutions, the opponent, and the players are the ones who are taking care of things in the field. You're not trying to always fire up your team.
During that playoff run, they did everything they could to make sure the game was continued, because they loved playing the game of soccer and they loved being with their teammates.
Look.
All right.
So sophomore year, when I was picked as the starter, I didn't even know what to think, because that was only my second year playing soccer, and being put in that position for a second year player was a huge step for me. And I just remember going back to my dad's car and just telling him, he just screamed for me out of joy. Me and Jonah have always been good friends throughout high school. We'd always practice together, try to get each other better, try to work on each other, not so much individually, and see how we could progress as a goalkeeping unit. We were always side by side to each other, number one and two, as far as the depth chart went. So we would always push each other at practice, try to see who could make the better saves, who could do better. And then when it came game time, whenever Jonah was out there, whenever I was out there, we would always applaud each other for what we could do out there, because we knew that we worked on that together and we got better as a
Yeah, our defense was able to have a great year this year. It led to me being able to have a great year this year. And really from the start, in the scrimmages, we knew that we had a lot of talent on defense. Our midfielders were able to play great defense, and even our forwards were. And we knew that we had a chance to really do something special this year. And the biggest turning point was the first game of the season, Shawnee, down 2-0. And we really had to realize that, hey, we have to play defense first. We can't just rely on our offense to score so many goals that other teams just can't catch up with us. It really started with the defense, and then we had to transition into offense, and we kept that mentality the rest of the year. After the Shawnee game, obviously coming back, beating them, and then right into the next game, and the next game, and the game after that.
Just being in the system for all 4 years, it really matured me, showed me the ways, from just looking up to other players, to show me how to play the roles that I needed to fulfill. I took it on my shoulders that, like, if we don't perform to a certain standards, like, that's my fault. And I give credit to every guy who helped me back there.
Early in the summer league process, I knew I wanted to be a bigger part of the team than I have been in the past. I kind of lit a fire under myself and just tried to play as good as I could every game and do everything that I could to help the team. And, you know, eventually that got us to championship, and I was just happy to be a part of that.
There's a point to when you can let the emotions get too much of you, I guess you could say. In our first game, I mentioned Shawnee, you're down 0-2. I was just getting frustrated because you didn't really have a lot of build-up play until later in the game. And so I got pulled off the field. Me and Meyer kind of went at it. I'd say that set the tone the rest of the season. And it was at the point where we were both kind of screaming at each other, but it wasn't because we were mad at each other, it was because we just wanted the team to do good. Sometimes you need a reset, but usually I try to take everything on the field personal, and that once I did, it would just make me play harder, I guess, because I'm kind of playing for my team and not just for myself. Sectional title, it was kind of like surreal because it didn't even really feel like I was playing in a championship game. It didn't really like set in until they brought out that trophy right at the end, and then I just saw my teammates hoist it up, and it was surreal, honestly.
Really, I can't even tell you how to explain my goals. I'm still, to this day, shocked and can't really believe that I was able to do that those last 5 or 6 games. And just, I think it was the competitiveness at practice and just everyone wanting to compete and knowing we really had a shot this year. and we were capable to do anything we set our minds to. I had an idea of where it would be and knew how to see the defense because I was a defender and know how they were going to react and just able to read his balls and then able to put them in the back of the net and just be able to contribute to that team offensively also was just something remarkable and I'll never forget it.
My sophomore year, we were playing against Robbinsville in a scrimmage, and I went up to Coach Myra and I asked him for a chance because I wasn't playing all that much at the time, and you know, he gave me the chance and I worked as hard as I could, and then for the next, you know, 2 years I've been just working as hard as I could to just prove that he made the right choice when he gave me that chance and that I could be a valuable asset to the team. That's something I'm always going to remember, just the excitement and joy that everyone was feeling at the time. It was crazy.
It was like 2 minutes left in the game and the teammate passed me the ball and I was looking at the net and I was thinking, where should I put it in my mind? And I just kick it into the net and I don't know how it came. It made me really happy because we were losing 1-0 and there were only like 2 minutes left in the game. Yes, it made me happy.
Looking to my left and seeing Drew Gallagher next to me running the beep test at level 15, to know that somebody else is pushing me like that, to have my teammates to push me all the time, Eric and Justin, Johnny, Mitch, Scotty, the whole team, to get into the season and to play through it with them was an honor. And just since we were little, you know, they were always such great leaders and I always looked up to them in that aspect. And to finally hear my name at the soccer ceremony to be called for captain, you know, and to shake Eric's hand and get a clap on the back from Johnny, that to me really defined, you know, this is what tireless effort ends up being.
It's called a team for a reason because nobody can do everything by themselves. Without my teammates, I'd say 75% of the goals I wouldn't have, so there goes the record. My teammates really had everything to do with me having the record, and it was very helpful.
So I've been playing with these guys since like fourth or fifth grade. I've pretty much known their passion, their grit, and all the work they put in this game. So there was no doubt in my mind that we were gonna just have another amazing season and that we were gonna fight for a sectional championship. And it came true. And it's because of these guys' passion. You don't find it anywhere else. So I think that was key.
So in the Lenape game, I felt we were all just kind of doing really well as a team that game. And we were just connecting our passes. We were getting what we needed to get. And I think everyone was working really well together that game to create great chances and opportunities for the team. My role was kind of just to come off the bench and keep the same intensity as the starter did. When you think of like a sub coming and you kind of think of it's going to be worse than the starter, but I like to look at it as just keep the same intensity as the starter. So that's what I try to do this season.
I think that game really summarized how the season was going to go. Being down 2-0, going into the second half, and then ultimately 15 minutes to go, coming back with 3 goals, beating Shawnee for the first time in school history on opening day. It's a pretty good kickstart for the season.
I always try and be the hardest working player on the field. It's all about the guys around me. It's all about bringing my team with me. It's not so much a personal goal, but a team goal. And I constantly always look around. If somebody's not working as hard, then I gotta work twice as hard. And it really just feeds off of that. And I got a great group of guys with me, but other than that, it's all about the team.
It was just a great experience, especially being the only freshman to win South Jersey. I mean, that was just a great feeling. The Shawnee opening game was just, it was something like I've never felt before. Just the rush of, like, just great energy went through. My dad, like, played at the same field that you coached him on and everything. It was just great energy.
All right, so for me, as a calming force, it's all just about when you're on the field, you know. When you're on the field, you're not worried about who you're playing against or who you're playing with. It's all about just what's going on in the game. So you get the ball, you move it, you keep going. You don't even worry about any of the other things. You stay cool, you stay calm, and the game just kind of works itself out. There's no need to really worry about it all that much. I found it easier when I just focused on what I was doing one step at a time. Obviously, look ahead before you get the ball, but I'm talking like don't be thinking about things in the future. You know, you have to test the next day, just be focused on the game, what's going on in the game.
Here I was looking up to guys like Pierce Adams, Sean Hines, and we had guys like Connor Freeze going up through the ranks, and
We kind of knew that we were having good teams and we had a good squad, but we were kind of missing something. We were kind of missing a championship to kind of show how good our season was. And looking at our roster going into this year, we had guys like Johnny, Justin, Mitch, Tommy, you know, and the rest of the squad. We knew this wasn't a team that we wanted to go without having a trophy or having something to show for it. So we kind of felt like it was our time. We were all motivated. We all knew how good we were on paper, and we just knew that if we just put it on the field and we worked hard and we prayed for each other, that we can get that sectional title that we were dreaming about for the past 4 years now. So that's why I kind of felt like it was our time.
Seneca boys soccer team opened its season Tuesday in a place it's very familiar with and hasn't known a lot of success. Seneca had an 0-15 all-time record against Shawnee High School and had been outscored in those games 38-5. There was little to suggest a change in those trends after a goal by Aiden Jaquinto in the first half and a thunderbolt from Ben Delmeyer in the second staked Shawnee to a 2-0 lead.
I told the guys, I said, you know, don't start pointing fingers. We had guys behind the ball. We had a couple guys even deflect it prior to the kids shooting. That's a fantastic shot. Like, he, as a former goalkeeper, you live with that and say, hey, dude, that's such a great shot. And then the second one, just unfortunate, you know, you learn by things like that.
Those goals didn't take any of the fight out of the Golden Eagles. They were convinced they could get the next one and convinced it would change the game. It was Eric Pierre who finally provided it.
We definitely didn't think we were playing poorly at all. We think we were moving the ball well. We were creating chances. Just midfield battles were our only struggle. And we just think once we got that one goal that the floodgates were open, and that's what happened. You know, I've been playing with number 17, Johnny Miaoui, my whole life. And when he picked up the ball on the right wing, I knew he wanted to chip it over the back line. And I just made a short little run. I put what I could on it, and luckily it went in.
Johnny Miaoui provided his second assist a moment later on a goal by Luke Leach. Scott Spruill put Seneca ahead for the first time a moment later. It had taken Seneca just 3 minutes, 7 seconds to score three times.
Yeah, I was anticipating a through ball to Johnny Miaoui, and it got caught up in a couple defenders and stayed after it and took a single touch and whipped it far corner. I knew it was going to hit the goalie. I didn't think it was going to hit his glove and go in.
A minute after Spruill's goal, Seneca keeper Jonah Mikulski put his mark on the game with a save that preserved the Golden Eagles' 3-2 win. Shawnee fell to 0-1 and will face Washington Township on Thursday.
About three quarters into the game, we liked how the game was going. We were up 2-0, and you know, I thought we played some decent stuff. We were organized defensively, but you know, we've obviously got to avoid that collapse at the end.
From Shawnee Stadium in Medford, this is John Lewis. Later on, the Golden Eagles of Seneca had a chance to clinch the Olympic Conference National Division with a win over second-place Cherry Hill West and responded with one of their best halves of the season.
We really thought, like, all right, we're clicking. And, you know, you wonder sometimes, you know, a couple of kids like, ah, night game, you know, we were off our routine a little bit, but you wouldn't know it, not the way they came in.
Luke Leach gave Seneca the lead about 10 minutes in.
I cut around a couple people. I pulled up, looked in front of me, saw the goalie was a little off his line, just hit it, hope for the best, and went bar down.
The Golden Eagles pressed for a second, but couldn't solve Lions keeper Ian Sachs. Cherry Hill West finally responded with a second-half goal by Zach Bruno.
You know, we were holding that lead, and we were, I don't want to say in control, but we were pretty comfortable with what we were doing. They got the goal in transition, and I was proud. Other than maybe about a minute or so, our guys bounced right back and just got back to business.
Sachs foiled Seneca's two best chances in overtime. Leach had the first at the end of a highlight reel run and off the right flank. The second was a quick shot over a scrum from John Mialli.
You know, it's really just doing it for the team at this point. They've given me so many opportunities, and I feel like I owed it to them to come up. Then the second half, I thought our reaction was amazing. Overtime, we played our hearts out, and sometimes we just can't get it.
A moment later, Mialli seemed to score the goal that sealed it, only to have that goal taken away on an offside call. In the end, the team settled for a 1-1 draw. The Golden Eagles can still win the National with two more league wins.
You know, these are two of the best refs we have, so, you know, I just got to say, I'll go with his angle, and, you know, I'm sure Dan Butler thought it was a great call for Cherry Hill West, but, you know, not so much here, but they're two great referees, so I trust their call.
From the pitches in the Pine Barrens, this is John Lewis. The Seneca boys soccer team found itself under siege in the early going of Monday's South Jersey Group 3 semifinal game. Morristown carried the play in the early going and took a 1-0 lead in the fourth minute on a goal by Dove McGuire-Burke.
They're a very good team, and they put us right on their heels, so I'll credit them. And the goal they scored was a fantastic goal. I mean, the kid didn't have a lot of space to shoot in, and he tucked it, and he tucked it in the corner, so credit to them.
The first 5 minutes of the game, we were a little sluggish, came out sleeping, and they put one in, and that really elevated how we played. And we just came out hungry as soon as they scored, and I mean, our goal happened maybe a few minutes right after that.
Tom Fox tied the game for Seneca with 16:15 left in the first half.
We got a big corner. Mitch put a perfect ball in right to my head, just came in and drilled it. Perfect header, couldn't ask for more.
The Golden Eagles took the lead on a goal by Drew Gallagher 15 minutes later.
Leach on the other run. He saw me the whole way, great unselfishness, played it right across the six, and I was there and the goalie was off his line and I was able to poke it in. So it was definitely a great feeling to be able to contribute to this team and help us out in our run.
Gallagher made it his first two-goal game of the season midway through the second half.
Recently, I've just been seeing him in all, the whole way and just put my head down and just saw it in the back of the net.
Seneca earned its first ever sectional final berth with a 3-1 win. Morristown's highlights in an 11-7-3 season included a win over top-seeded Triton and a shutout win over Delran on September 24th.
Everybody thought this was a rebuilding year. You know, we lose seven seniors from last year at the starting lineup, and now we only have three seniors in the starting lineup now. And they could have easily folded and said, look, it's not our year, but they didn't. They worked hard every day, and we played every team hard. Every single team, every time we went out on that field, we played hard. And I'm very proud of them. I mean, you can't ask for anything more. And, you know, at the end, they wind up better than the team that we had last year.
From Seneca High School, this is John Lewis.
We ain't come this far to get this far. Let's get this game done.
Seneca on 3, 1, 2, 3!
Seneca!
Before a hero could emerge in front of the Pinelands net in Thursday's South Jersey Group 3 championship game, one had to make himself known in Seneca's end. Senior goalkeeper Jonah Mikulski kept the Golden Eagles net empty during a key early stretch about 27 minutes in when Dominic DeSantis got loose on the right side.
Oh, he had a really nice breakaway down on the right side, and by the angle that he was at, I didn't really want to come out because I thought there was still a possibility he would cross it. He ended up hitting a nice shot. It would have been near post top corner, but I was lucky enough to get my hands on it, got over the bar, and then we set up defense for the corner.
The corner wasn't exactly easy to handle either, but with those obstacles negotiated, Seneca could turn its attention to offense, and Captain Eric Pierre could take care of his business.
Ball wouldn't have went in without John Meowie's cross. It was put on a platter for me. I was just hoping to get something on it. Luckily, I did, and I'm glad that I got to score the decider.
What a poised, composed kid, and this goal today was coming for a while. I think he felt a little snake bitten. He's hit some posts and hit some just wide. And he had his opportunity today and he buried it. But yeah, the goal is just, you know, the product of all the hard work and great things he does and great positions he gets into.
The Golden Eagles had some solid chances to double their lead, but a second goal never came. More and more as the game moved on, Seneca focused on defending what it had.
It allows me to be a little more conservative so I can feel a little more comfortable. We don't have to push to get that goal. And it really just helps bring everyone together. We stay more compact and it just helps us overall secure the win.
We know that they're going to come out flying and they're going to push more guys forward during the second half. We knew we had to weather a storm, and we've played games like that before and we've won games like that before, so we knew what we had to do, and luckily we were good enough to get it done.
Seneca earned its first ever soccer sectional championship with a 1-0 victory. The Golden Eagles will face Central Jersey champ Ocean Township Tuesday at Rowan University.
Let's focus on not leaving anything out on that field any day we go out. And believe me, that goes for practice too. And that's more a product, a result of them rather than me. And we've done that. We've put a lot of days together. And you know, the best thing now is we get to practice again tomorrow.
From Seneca High School, this is John Lewis.
I'm just blessed that I was able to be a part of this program for 4 years, and with a great coaching staff and the great group of guys that I've been playing with since I was 8, 9 years old. So it's been a hell of a ride, and I'm just glad I was able to experience this.
From Toms River High School North, this is John Lewis.
Why? Wow.